You're watching a quick guide on how to live stream IRL using your phone's camera. This is one of multiple ways that you can live stream from your phone, but today we'll be focusing on the use case of using it indoors or outdoors just using the camera. So no, there's no gaming involved. I'm gonna tell you a quick reminder to follow me on Twitch and then let's begin. First thing you want to do is go to your phone's app store and download the Stream Elements app. Once it's installed, you open it and then you will have to log in with whatever account you will be using to live stream, whether it's Twitch or YouTube. From there, you're gonna have three main tabs. Streamer View gives you the possibility to see your activity feed, so if someone follows, subscribes, or whatever, you can see it there. You can also display your chat directly from there. Then we have Audience View, which is exactly what your audience will be seeing once you are live. The difference between Streamer View and Audience View is that Audience View will show you your overlays. Yes, you will be able to add overlays. I'm going to show you how. It's pretty simple. When it comes to the camera tab, your options are Switch, where you can switch from the front camera to the back camera, Mute Audio, if you want to mute yourself. This is very practical if you're talking to someone you don't want to broadcast the conversation, or if you're saying anything like sensitive information. You can mute video, so basically show a blank video for a little bit if you don't want to show certain things. And then you'll have features. When it comes to features, you have options between manual focus, change orientation, and flash. Manual focus means that you can tap on the screen to pick the focus and then it's not going to move. Then change orientation, you can go from portrait to landscape, of course. And then flash, where you can activate the flash. Again, in Streamer View, you can show the activity feed, so every recent event, it's going to pop up, or you can tap chat. You cannot show both of them at once, apparently. In Audience View, you can enable or disable the alert box, meaning that if you're getting follow botted or if people are making, you know, rude names in order to follow you just so that it shows up on screen, you have the possibility to hide that while you're live on your phone. And then we will have stream settings, where you can change the name of the stream. Doesn't give you the option to change the category though. All right, apart from those three main tabs, you also have a menu top left. If you click on it, you will see your profile, your email address for some reason, your stream title, and your viewer count, I believe. Then you can click on stream settings, where you can turn off your viewer count, for example. You can use Bluetooth audio if you're using a Bluetooth device. You can set up your video resolution, bitrate, and frame rate, and a couple more options. Basically, when you're all set up, all you have to do is press that big red button, and then you will go live. Now, if you do want some overlays, you will have to go to Stream Elements' website in order to set them up. So you want to go to streamelements.com, log in with the same account from the same platform you want to stream on, and under your overlays, you will find something called mobile. It will create it automatically. Just click edit and you should have a couple of widgets that are there by default. You can add whatever you want. If you want like a labels bar, you want to add an image, you want to add a tip jar, you can do all of that right in here and place them. Now keep in mind, for the size and the placements, you don't want anything to be basically straight in the middle or anything like that. People are gonna want to look at your camera. In my case, I decided to put a labels bar up top. I decided to have my alert box a little small on the right side. I have a tip cup or a tip jar on the right, on the bottom right, and then I'll have my chat box bottom left, pretty small. Once you're done, you can just click save and it will update directly on your phone and you're basically ready to stream. If it doesn't update, you can close the app and open it back up again. All right, now let's talk about gear. Now, I always want to travel light and I always have a backpack on me. First thing that I want to have is a retractable selfie stick, of course, with a phone mount. And then this selfie stick also comes with this metal tripod. It doesn't have to be metal, but make sure that you have something where you can put the selfie stick down in case you want to sit down and take a break or something like that. It screws at the bottom just like that, and boom, I have a tripod. I can also extend it like this, and boom, it's extended, and I can quickly fold it. Boom, boom, and we're ready to go. Now, it's super useful to have your phone like this because it keeps it at a distance so the camera is not all up in your face, and you can bring it back if you want to actually read chat a little bit better and then pull it back out to show whatever you're showing. The only problem with the distance is that you will need a microphone that is closer to you so that you don't have to get close to the phone in order to speak, to be heard, but also you don't want any environment noise to overpower your voice. Now, back then it was super easy to get a lav mic that has a pretty long cord and then you would plug it in the jack port, but modern phones have a single port and their USB-C. So for now, I am using the Comica VD Live 10, which allows me to just plug one part into the phone and use either one of those mics as a live mic. So with that little thing, I can just do this, put it in my shirt, and boom, I have a mic system going on. Now, another essential product that you'll need is a power bank in order to charge your phone. If you're gonna be streaming with your phone, it's gonna drain the battery pretty fast. This one is in 8,800 milliamps, and it has multiple full charges for my phone on it. The problem is that I cannot plug it in while I'm also using the mic since it's only one part. What you can do is buy an adapter. There are some pretty cheap adapters that you can buy that allow you to charge the phone and also use that part for music or, in that case, microphones. Now, when it comes to the gear. I know I'm always telling you that you can start with what you have. The truth is, yes, you can start live streaming with your phone by just holding it and using the onboard microphone. In my opinion, in order to have a good experience in allowing you to stream for long hours, this is basically the basic. The selfie stick with a tripod extension, the microphone, and the power bank are the basics basically to have a proper IRL streaming setup. If you want to go even further, you can see at the top of my phone mount right here, I have what is called a cold shoe mount, meaning that I could put a tiny light if I wanted to, but I'm not going to go into this. This is not something that I use. So you decide if you want to go with something like that. Now make sure you check the description of this video because I'm going to put a list of all the things that I mentioned or any products that are as close as possible. This is another reminder for you to follow me on Twitch. I've been streaming more often and I'm starting to include more IRL outdoors live streams since I live in Paris. We did the Eiffel Tower a couple days ago. It was amazing. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions. I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level out.